चेतन जी कोनापुरे, असिस्टेंट प्रोफेसर डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ सिविल इंजीनियरिंग वालचंद इंस्टीट्यूट ऑफ टेक्नोलॉजी सोलापुर. दीज आर द लर्निंग आउटकम्स. एट द एंड ऑफ दिस सेशन स्टूडेंट विल बी एबल टू आइडियलाइज द स्ट्रक्चर एज अनडैम्प्ड फोर्स वाइब्रेशन सिस्टम. इवन द स्टूडेंट कैन ड्रॉ फ्री बॉडी डायग्राम ऑफ दैट सिस्टम. एंड द लास्ट आउटकम इज राइटिंग द इक्वेशन ऑफ मोशन फॉर अनडैम्प्ड फोर्स वाइब्रेशन. Now this is the example which explains you the forced vibration system. This is the example, simple pendulum which is shown in figure 1. This mass is subjected to time dependent force Ft. So this force is acting during the vibration of system, that's why it is called as forced vibration system. Earlier two videos were of free vibration system. Now forced vibration means during the entire vibration period, so time dependent force is acting on that body, or the time dependent force is leading oscillation or vibration in that body. Now this is idealization of the structure. Now every physical system is a continuous system having distributed mass and elasticity. This is the important statement for idealization. For every system we have to adopt this statement. Next is assumptions for idealization of the structure, how these are useful in every system that I will explain to you. Now first assumption is total mass of a story is concentrated at its floor level, which is lumped mass system. Now second is girders in a building are infinitely rigid. And third is effect of axial forces are neglected. These three idealizations assumptions are there. Let us see how these are useful. Now the example is there which is used to explain the undamped forced vibration. First example is reciprocating machine exert dynamic force on supporting structure. Now this frame is the supporting structure. This is reciprocating machine. When it starts, it exerts some motion, and due to that motion the time dependent force actually exerted on the structure, and the structure is subjected to vibration. So this M is mass of this story which is lumped at floor level. This is the first assumption. So the majority of the mass is at the floor level, so that's why the mass is lumped at the floor level, so that we can analyze the mass of this entire system. Second, these are two columns. These two columns are providing elastic resistances. And why is the displacement which is common for both these two columns? How it is possible? When the effect of axial forces are neglected, or second assumption is there, the girder is infinitely rigid. So girder is infinitely rigid, then only the y displacement is common or same for these two columns. And third assumption is there, the effect of axial forces are neglected, so that the column's length or height will not alter or modify. So these assumptions are made for this purpose, so that the displacement will remain same for both the columns. Now this single story frame is idealized as lumped mass system. Let's see what is a lumped mass system. You can see one mass and this K. K is the stiffness which represents these two columns. M is the mass, and when the time dependent force is acting on this mass, Y is the displacement. So very single sketch is there which explains this entire example of reciprocating machine supporting on the structure. Now this lumped mass system, actually one conceptual model is required to solve the problem. So this is the conceptual model. It is also known as wagon wheel model. So this is wagon M, which is representing the mass of the body. This is subjected to the time dependent force Ft, and it is connected to the fixed base or any support by means of the spring, which represents the stiffness of the column. So our structure, single story frame, is converted into the conceptual model, wagon wheel model. So this figure 2, which is a single story frame idealized as a single degree of freedom system. Now I will put one question here. This question is, what is the type of force exerted by the reciprocating machine? Now there are four options also. You just see these options. A is a static force, B harmonic force, C random force, D is non-harmonic force. What is the answer for this? You pause the video, think on that and write on the answer. Now the answer is harmonic force. How it is harmonic force? Let's see. Here the example is shown, or this sketch is shown here. Whenever this time dependent force is acting on the mass, this mass vibrates both sides of the neutral position. Vertical line of this pendulum is the neutral position, and this mass is vibrating on both sides, displacements are occurring on both sides, that's why it is called as harmonic force, or these type of excitations are also known as harmonic excitations. Now, this wagon wheel model is solved for further outcome, that is the last, which is free body diagram and equation of motion. Now, let's isolate the body from all point of contacts. Then this body is isolated. This body is isolated, and mark the forces at respective points. So this is inertia force and elastic force. So the spring is removed, and at that point there some resistance is marked, that is elastic force. And when this is, why is the direction of motion or displacement y is occurred, and inertia force is marked, which is opposite to the direction of motion. Now this is figure A, which is a free body diagram of the mass. For time dependent force is acting towards right, Ft. Now the free body diagram is ready. Now we have to write the proper equation of motion, which is a mathematical model for this. Y is the displacement of mass, y dot is velocity of the mass, and y double dot is acceleration of the mass. Now this conceptual model, wagon wheel model, it is solved and the free body diagram is made. Only the thing is that inertia force and elastic force quantification is required. After this quantification, we can solve this problem. Now, next is how this inertia force is marked opposite to the direction of motion. The force of inertia, which is resistance against change in the body. So, body is displacing towards right, that's why inertia force is towards left. So, what is the quantification for that? Actually, inertia force is rate of change of momentum, which is also I have explained in the first video also. So, whatever acceleration is induced in that body into the mass of that body, that will give you the inertia force. So my double dot is the inertia force, which is marked opposite to the direction of motion. Okay, this is possible by D'Alembert principle. By applying D'Alembert principle, the inertia force is marked on this body, and dynamic equilibrium equation is written here. Now next is elastic force or elastic resistance. So the resistance against the deformation is the elastic force, and always it is proportional to the displacement of the body. So that's why the quantification for that is K into Y. K is the stiffness of the body. So stiffness of the body into the displacement, that will give you the force, which is elastic force. Now these two forces are towards left, time dependent force is acting towards right. Now why is the direction of motion or displacement? Now the figure 3b is the dynamic equilibrium of body. Now we have to apply the summation fx is equal to 0 by D'Alembert principle. Now whenever the summation fx is equal to 0 is applied, all horizontal forces are considered. These two forces are towards left, one force, external force or excitation, is towards right. Now this is minus my double dot minus ky is equal to time dependent force Ft, or actually this inertia force is negative, elastic force is negative, Ft time dependent force is positive, equal to 0. This is the actual mathematical equation. So after rearrangement we will get this equation. So my double dot plus ky is equal to 0 is the mathematical equation for undamped force vibration. Now what is the importance of this equation? What is the significance of equation? Whenever we observe this, my double dot ky is equal to Ft, that is undamped force. But the meaning or significance of the equation is, for any body in which damping we are not considering, then the resistance offered by the body against deformation is elastic resistance. Resistance against the change in the body, that is the inertia resistance or inertia force. So summation of elastic resistance and summation of inertia force, that will counterbalance the effect of external dynamic force. So inertia force plus elastic force, both are counterbalancing the effect of this external dynamic force Ft. Now, after rearrangement, this is the final mathematical equation, which is equation number 1, my double dot plus ky is equal to Ft. This is the mathematical equation of undamped force vibration. Now, above equation is differential equation, and this differential equation we have to solve to determine this y, which is the displacement basic parameter of this equation. Now, what is the order of this equation? And next thing is, what is the type of this differential equation it is? Now, the order of the equation is second, m y double dot. You can see here, y double dot, actually that is the acceleration quantity, but this is the order of equation. Now, right hand side of the equation is not zero. The time dependent force is present. That's why it is non-homogeneous equation. So, this differential equation is second order non-homogeneous equation. When we solve the second order non-homogeneous equation, and if we determine y, then we can quantify the value of displacement in the undamped force vibration. These are the references which are used for the above session. Thank you.